My name is Richard Anson. I'm founder and CEO of a business called Revue.com. Revue is a shopping advisory web business that takes the power of customer reviews, so user-generated reviews, and turns that into advice to help people purchase electrical products. I did a degree in geology originally, and when I finished geology, I thought I wanted to go into business, and I went and took a job with 3i in venture capital. And one of the reasons for taking that job in venture capital was to get the skills to go in and build a business. And I soon realized that actually being in the investment side doesn't actually give you the skills to run a business. So at that point, I actually left and went back and became an engineer. I did a PhD in engineering geology, and then went and worked as an engineering consultant for about 5 years before going off to do an MBA. Everything I've done has been right for me at the right time, and all the skills that I picked up have sort of built on each other. What I found interesting was I'd done my degree and then gone out and worked and then come back to do research, and I think that is slightly different to if you just finish your first degree and go straight off and stay into academia. So you've seen the pressures involved in a working paid working life or a business life about having to deliver. So I applied myself pretty diligently and pretty rigorously to it. Doing a PhD, you have to be very entrepreneurial. I think most PhD students don't realize it, but the only way your PhD gets done is if you get up in the morning and do it yourself, and you're not doing it for money. You're doing it for the love of and passion of a project, and it gives you an amazing attention to detail and an amazing kind of rigor in terms of questioning any data. And engineering geology, my PhD was in landslides. Engineering geology is a very applied subject, so it's very natural to go and work in industry after doing that. And I worked effectively as a geotechnical engineer in a civil engineering consultancy, so you're always there blending academia, engineering with commerce. And I was 29 after spending five years in engineering consulting, that I actually wanted to be more in the business side. And it was that point I made a decision to go off and do an MBA and fund that myself. And actually now, if I'm recruiting people and I look at somebody who has a CV and they've done the same thing all the time, I find it very dull and it doesn't inspire me. Whereas someone who's done a variety of different things, they have a sort of degree of flexibility and agility of the mind, probably. When I went to manage consultants, I went in with really a view that I would be there for a period of time before starting a business. So I hadn't decided, my aim wasn't to be there forever. And it's fairly standard. It's not an unstandard route for people to do if you go and do an MBA. But that's not to say that change throughout my career has been easy. So, you know, when I've had periods unemployed, etc., when I've decided to make a change, and it then takes time for you to find the next role. I tend to try and feed off lots of different people, actually. So now I'll try and build relationships with other entrepreneurs who are potentially 5-10 years ahead. So they've been successful once or even twice, and meeting them for a drink or you learn all the war stories, and you actually realize that whatever you're going through at the moment, whether it's good or bad, there's someone else has been through it, and they can help kind of coach and provide support or advice. It's good to be building something and doing something constructive. You know, Revue's still got a long way to go. I'm very proud of what we've achieved in the last 5 years, but we want to move across Europe, and the business has got a long way to go.